Hi, and welcome to this new Plan With Me video in my Mush Planner. I have a slightly different video for you today, as I've recently done a Q&A on my Instagram, and I have some questions that I would like to answer and make this a bit more chatty. Before I dive into the questions, I just want to tell you what you're seeing on screen right now. I'm whiting out the bottom part of the planner, adding in the bottom washi, then cutting up the full boxes so I can pre-layer them on my pages. And I am using some Simply Gilded washi to spruce things up a bit. Right, so then, to the questions. So thank you so much for submitting the questions. I really enjoyed reading them, and now I'm gonna enjoy answering them. I received a few questions on my favorite planner brand, and I am going to cheat a tiny bit because I'm going to give my top five in no particular order. I'm going to start with Simple Stories and Carpe Diem. They are absolutely amazing. I love their brand, I love the designs, and I love them. They are my Ogden family, and I'm looking forward to seeing them again. I also really enjoy Kiki K. It's the first brand that I was able to shop in real life in their London stores, and they're just really fabulous. Also in my top five are both Erin Condren and The Happy Planner. I love their products, I love their planners, I love all their accessories, also buying and hoarding them, but I do really use them and they are fab. Then lastly, not per se a planner brand, but they do have planners and they do have a lot of stationery, is Kate Spade. Kate Spade is my everything. I love their products. Their bangles are everything to me, and I really enjoy wearing them. But also their planners, and especially their stationery items, are just really pretty, and it's so fun to be able to use them. Continuing on this theme, what is my favorite planner type? So I'm definitely a vertical girl. I need lists. My brain works in lists and crossing them off. And a vertical layout helps my brain into seeing things either chronologically or prioritizing. And that, I think, is why I really like the Erin Condren vertical, the Happy Planner vertical, and here on the screen, the Musha Planner vertical. With the other planners that I either use or experiment with, all have been vertical. Although, funnily enough, my favorite calendar app has a horizontal layout. Now that I'm thinking about it, that it's really, really interesting to me. But also, on that app, let me know if you want to link. It color codes for me, and that really helps. And I don't color code my planners, so maybe that's why that specific layout works for me. Anyway, back to the questions. What is my ultimate planner and or my perfect planner? Well, it would definitely need to be vertical layout, maybe going towards an hourly layout, because I do use my planners chronologically. So for me, the top is the start of the day and the bottom is the end of the day. Also, it would need to be colorful. There needs to be lots of accessories that I'm able, well, let's be honest, stickers and washi that I'm able to use. The pens need to be sparkly. I'm decorating now. This is my decorating brain. This is not my functional planning brain. Like I said, I don't need color coding in my planner, but I do need, the paper needs to be soft, a bit thicker, that I can use my felt tip pens in there. And this sort of A5 size would be probably perfect for me. Well, it's an A5 wide, I should say. I will definitely think about this some more, because I do feel that I'm somewhat on planner piece. I'm really happy with everything now, so it will definitely be a mix of all those sort of types of planners. But important, bigger than an A5, vertical layout, nice paper, colorful. That would be, yeah, I think that's it. Just interrupting the Q&A, I'm almost done with the base of my spread. So the washi is down, the date covers are down, and I'm just finishing up the sidebar. Next step will be the full boxes, putting them down prettily all over the pages. And then I am ready to go into my stash and use the stickers there to build my spread. So the next question is, what was my first contact with planners? So I always have had a stationery obsession, and I blame my mum for this. When I was still a toddler, we would go to the school campus, which is the sort of back to school extravaganza we would have in basically all the big department stores here in the Netherlands. And I would be allowed to get like a new eraser or a new pencil. And that was like, honestly, the highlight of my year. So I have planners from when I was 7. It's more a diary, but I do have planners and school agenda, so school diaries school planners from 8, 9, 10, 11. It's cute and it's Forever Friends and it has kittens in there. It's adorable. And then in high school and at university, I used the planners that were Cool and Moleskin for a lot of years. And so I've always used stationery and planners. But how did I get into planner as I'm doing it now? 5 years ago, almost to the day, I recently celebrated my planniversary. I saw the Planning 101 video by Elle Fowler, or Glam Planner, and it was through a video from Masha, who is actually the maker of this planner, that I found out about the planning world, and I have honestly never looked back. What are my favorite shops for creative goodies? So I buy a lot on Etsy from different independent sellers. Links down below, you can find my favorite shops. On the high street, I really enjoy Sossen & Grene, Action, Peepo's, yeah, as well, or Flying Tiger. Also, the bigger department stores here have paper chases, so that's always fun. And otherwise, I do shop a lot online, just because we don't really have like the big Michaels, Hobby Lobby, Joann's, as you do have in the States, or even Hobbycraft in the UK. But we do have a few specialist stores in the Netherlands, and they are Scrapwereld in Almere, and Scrap Delight in Linschoten, and also the other big Dutch retailer that I order from is Paper District. I do also buy a lot from AliExpress, that was the next question. I get stationery from there, and washi, sometimes stickers, and also things for my house and my life, so things like sunglasses or scarves, and cute bags in shape of houses that are pink and absolutely adorable. And please look at my Instagram, because that bag is somewhere and it is my jam. So two questions that I got that I think I might need to make a separate video for. One was, could you please show your functional planner? Is that something that you do want to see? It is. I'm slightly hesitant to do that because there's a lot of things for work in there and I don't think I should share that online. But I can make a video about it and explain how I make that work for me, because as you even see on the screen, it's very decorative and it does have a function for me, but it's not really what you would say functional, and I do get that. And also how I make my inserts, I think that needs to have like a completely different video, which ties into the next question. Will I ever reopen my inserts shop? I don't think so. My shop, The Lizard Papers, has been on break for a while now. It just got too busy. I was unable to keep up with demand, and I unfortunately made some mistakes, and I decided that it was better to close my shop and really do a sort of rethink about everything. In my mind, it's still temporary. I might open as a printable shop, but honestly, I'm doing YouTube at the moment, and that's taking more of my creative energy, and I think I should focus on that right now. Meanwhile, I am working on my spread. As I mentioned before, the top is the morning and the bottom is the evening for me. And I'm just filling out everything per day using my sticker stash. The kit does have the some decorative stickers, and of course the full boxes, half boxes and quarter boxes. And I use all the stickers that I have to sort of mix and match and really get everything looking really nice and fun and dynamic. So, question, how do I use my Happy Planner? I use it as a memory planner. I just stick stickers in there because it makes me happy, and in that sense it's not functional at all. And I buy my Happy Planner stuff either at shops here, online, or I have them from the trips that I made abroad. In 2018, I visited the United States twice, and in 2019, I also visited the United States twice, and I went to Canada twice, so I was able to pick up a lot of the Happy Planner stuff, and that was amazing. You have seen me finish up the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I'm just working on Thursday and also Friday at the moment. I do try to work per day, and in front of me on the table, I have all my different binders. Recently, I sorted out these binders. I first had all my stickers, so character stickers and icon stickers, by shop, and I switched to by category. You can actually see this on my Instagram TV. I really, really, really like this. I thought I had made a mistake because I made such a mess and it was such a big job to put everything in the right order, but by category works marvelously for me. So I have all my work stickers together. I have all my washi stickers together. I have all my food and grocery stickers together. And it has really changed my planning game, and that really pleases me. While I am finishing the spread, I have quick fire round of random questions. What was my favorite subject in school? I really enjoyed school and university and learning in general. I really still do. And my favorite subjects in school, if I look at high school, were definitely Latin and Greek and physics and math. I sound like a total nerd. I do get that, but it's fine because I totally am. And I embrace that of myself. The lovely Sophie wants to know why I love bagels so much. Well, girl, you got me on the bagel train again. So why do you love bagels so much? And I also received a ton of comments about being fabulous and gorgeous. So thank you. That was really kind. And I love you, girls. Connecting to that, I had a question about my skincare routine. I don't really have one. And I know that is not smart because I am 33 and I need to work on that some more. I do have good genes. Thank you, mom and dad. And I use just moisturizing cream and clean my face with cleansers, but everything is just from drugstores and nothing really fancy. But thank you for thinking that I have nice skin. On the last question already, if I could travel anywhere, where would I go? So very, very, very high on my list is Japan. I was there in 2009 and it was both everything that I thought it would be and nothing that I thought it would be. I studied Japanese culture and also the Japanese language. 私は少し日本語がわかります。And it would be great to go back and revisit and shop all the stationery and planner items because I need... Phew, done with all the chatting and also done with my planner spread, or at least almost. Just finishing up some final things on Sunday with stickers and some writing. And then I'm just going through the sticker sheets of the kit to make sure that everything is in my planner. And it is! Here you can see the final spread. It's super fun and bright and I'm really pleased with how it looks. So I hope you enjoyed seeing how I do my Masha planner, and if you want a more talky through video next time, let me know and I will explain everything more in depth. In the meantime, if you have any questions, leave a comment down below, and you can also visit my Instagram for more inspiration and more Masha planner spreads.